legal, orderly, and humane immigration policy has been the lifeblood of America. But that's not what we're talking about. In fact, the Biden administration has outsourced our immigration policy to criminal cartels for at least the last 3 years. The public record will demonstrate that I've been very sympathetic, as we all are, to the plight of these children who came here through no fault of their own and who've been placed in litigation limbo for the last 12 years. President Obama, who issued the executive memorandum, admitted multiple times that he did not have the authority to do this, but then he did it, resulting in the litigation that we've seen over the last 10 years. I think it's tragic that as a result of this action by the Obama administration, these young people have been led to believe that this somehow provided a firm foundation for their integration into the great American heartland. But unfortunately, the conversation we're having here today needs to be placed in the proper context. 9 million illegal entries into the United States since the Biden administration took over, 108,000 dead Americans last year because of drugs that come across the southwestern border. The criminal organizations that move millions of people across know they're overwhelming our capacity to deal with it. And so then that's when when the Border Patrol is off the front lines, that's when the drugs come across, including the fentanyl that killed 71,000 Americans last year alone. And then there's the 400,000 unaccompanied minors that have been placed with sponsors in the United States, and the Biden administration says it's not our responsibility. We don't know what's happening to them. We don't know whether they're being trafficked for sex, being forced into labor, or what. I was in the Oval Office when President Obama said he was contemplating issuing an executive memorandum on the DREAM Act. We asked him, I was among those who asked him, please give us a chance to pass legislation. And we know that he declined to do that, and here we are today. This is the Committee of Jurisdiction that deals with immigration policy, but we haven't had a single hearing on fixing the broken system. Maybe components of it, like looking through a soda straw while ignoring the fire that's occurring all around us. Well, Senator Graham did a good job of explaining the numbers of where we are today, but it's become increasingly difficult for the Biden administration to sweep this problem under the rug. They have the tools available to them, the same laws that were in effect during the Trump administration, to deal with much of this problem, but they simply refuse to do so. And then there's the pull factors that Senator Graham alluded to. For example, last month, the city of Denver, Colorado, published a newcomers playbook welcoming migrants into their community. As a part of their intake process, they suggest immediately offering migrants onward transportation to another destination. Just this week, the mayor of Chicago had to scrap a poorly conceived plan to relocate minors to a neighborhood in South Chicago ahead of the Democratic National Convention. And President Biden continues to poison the well to good faith bipartisan attempts to address this problem. It's impossible for us to pass legislation dealing with this larger problem when President Biden simply refuses to enforce the law, creating a huge magnet to more and more immigration. For example, authorities that were intended to be exercised on a case-by-case basis, the so-called parole authority, has been exploited by President Biden to stand up entirely new programs that Congress has not agreed to. For example, the Department of Homeland Security set up a program to grant parole and work permits to 30,000 people a month from Cuba, Haiti, Nicaragua, and Venezuela. That's 360,000 people a year simply waved into the country, given a work permit, and there you go. The president has also expanded eligibility under the already unlawful Central American Minors Program to certain adults. Last year, the administration extended Venezuela's temporary protected status designation to cover nearly a half a million Venezuelans who illegally immigrated to the United States. The Biden administration knows, just as the Obama administration did when it came to DACA, that these programs are built on quicksand. Anyone enrolled in these programs is likely and has in fact experienced tremendous uncertainty, not as a result of the policies we have in place today, but the policies they put in place before, as far back as 12 years ago. Now, you've heard our colleagues say, well, we just need to take care of the Dreamers and DACA recipients. But the fact is they don't seem to care about the rest of the problems, including the 108,000 dead Americans as a result of the drugs and 400,000 minor children placed with sponsors that they simply have lost track of. So unfortunately, Democrats, through their unwillingness to address these manifold problems and the president's continued abuse of authorities, have made it impossible and foolish for us to take up a standalone DACA bill at this time.